Teacher Isa here and welcome to my channel. For today's video, I am going to discuss about actual and approximate time. But before that, if you have not subscribed yet to my YouTube channel, please don't forget to click on the subscribe button and hit on the notification bell for you to get notified every time I upload a new video. Our learning objectives for today's discussion: differentiate actual time from approximate time, and solve the actual and approximate time of the given problems. From the previous videos, I have emphasized that when we find the interest, whether it be on deposits or on loans, the time should always be expressed in years. We will not encounter problems if the time is expressed in years. However, there are some cases wherein we must be the ones to find the time. Therefore, we must have an agreement in finding the time to be considered in the transaction, especially if the time to be determined is between two dates. When the time is expressed between two dates, it is necessary to determine the actual and approximate time. Actual time or exact time is determined by counting each day of each month of the term except the origin date, while approximate time is determined by assuming each month to have 30 days and then counting each day of each month except the origin date. For example, find the actual and approximate time from March 23, 2005 to October 16, 2005. So we're going to solve for the actual days and the approximate days. So we have to count the number of days, the remaining days, for the month of March. Since the starting date or the origin date is March 23, to solve for the actual days, we know that March has 31 days. So 31 minus 23, we have 8 days. And for the approximate days, we have to assume that all months of the year has 30 days. 30 minus 23, we have 7. For the month of April, the actual number of days is 30. The approximate days is also 30. For the month of May, the actual number of days is 31. And for the approximate days is 30. For the month of June, the actual number of days is 30. And the approximate days is also 30. For the month of July, we have 31 actual number of days, 30 approximate days. For the month of August, we have 31 actual number of days and 30 approximate days. For the month of September, we have 30 days. And for the approximate days, we have 30. For the month of October, we have 16 days, both for the actual and approximate days. So if we're going to add these numbers, we'll have the actual number of days equal to 207. And the approximate days equal to 203. So that is how we're going to solve for the actual days and approximate days. Therefore, the actual number of days from March 23 to October 16, 2005 is 207 days, and the approximate number of days is 203 days. We can also solve it this way. To solve for the actual time or the actual number of days, we have the given or the origin date, which is March 23, and the end of term is October 16. So we're going to use this table, and from this table, each day is numbered from 1 to 365. So the given date, which is our origin date, is March 23. And March 23 is the 82nd day of the year. While the last day, we have October 16, It's the 289th day of the year. So we now have the number of days from January 1 to March 23, 82. And from January 1 to October 16, we have 289 days. To solve for the actual number of days, we have to find the difference between 289 and 82. So the answer is 207 days. We still have the same result to the first solution that we had. The alternative solution in solving for approximate time or approximate day, first step is we have to express the dates in numerals. Starting from October 16, 2005. So we're going to convert this into the format year, month, and day. So we'll have 2005 for the year, 10 for the month since we have October. October is the 10th month of the year. And we have the day 16. For March 23, 2005, we'll have 2005, 3, 23. After expressing the dates in numerals, we're going to use the subtraction operation, starting from the day column. So 16 minus 23, since we cannot subtract 23 from 16, we're going to borrow 1 from the month column. So 10 will become 9, and 16 will become 46. Since we borrowed 1 from the month column, and in solving for the approximate days, we have to assume that all months of the year has 30 days. So we will be adding 30 to 16. So that is why we have 46. Now we can subtract 46 with 23. We'll have the result, 23. And for the month column, we have 9 minus 3 is 6. So multiplying 60 by 30, we'll have 180 plus 23 days equal to 203 days. So the approximate number of days is 203 days. Still the same result to the first solution that we had. Take note that in finding the time between dates, usually the first day is excluded but the last day is included. Try solving this problem on your own for 1 minute. Find the actual and approximate time from July 6 to December 17 of the same year. Timer. Time is up. The answer is 187 days for the actual days, and for the approximate days, we have 161 days. So there are 4 different time factors possible in counting the number of days between two dates. When we consider the 360 or 365, we'll use 366 if leap year in a denominator. We express the number of days as a fraction of a year. We study the following. First, exact time over 365. Second, approximate time over 365. Third, the exact time divided by 360. And the last, approximate time divided by 360. The use of either of the first or the second yield us or give us the exact interest. The third or fourth yield ordinary interest. When the day of the origin date and the day when the loan is due are the same, we simply count the number of months between them. For example, January 15, 2021 to May 15, 2021. The origin date and the due date are the same. We just simply count the number of months between January 15 to May 15. And it gives us the answer 4 months. When the month and the day are the same for the origin date and the maturity date, we just count the number of years between them. For example, March 20, 2018 to March 20, 2021. So since the month and the day are the same for the origin date and the maturity date, we just count the number of years between March 20, 2018 to March 20, 2021. So we'll have the answer equal to 3 years. Another method is to subtract the year loaned from the year to be repaid, which is 2021 minus 2018 is 3 years.